Lay low, I was. Money you lost when you don't chase it. What you looking at me for? Should be looking at bankroll. Money you lost when you don't chase it. What you looking at me for? Should be looking at bankroll.
Hey y'all, I'm back with another tutorial, and today I'm gonna show you how to make a strawberry shortcake or a strawberry crunch cake. So the things you will need is strawberries, strawberry glaze. I got this from Walmart. You will need a stick of butter, strawberry and vanilla jello, your bowls, some all-purpose flour, strawberry cake, golden Oreos, or you can use the chessmen and your icing. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is put your jellos in two different bowls. Now you're gonna add your flour. So I use 1/4 cup for both. I always have to use more for the strawberry because it is jello and the vanilla is actually pudding. Your sticks of butter. I like to mix the flour in the mix first. And I always do the vanilla first because if you do the strawberry, then you'll have pink in your vanilla. And I just want to take your hand and smush the butter, mixing it with the mix until you get a crumble. Almost as wet sand. I'm going to spread that on a cookie sheet. And I'm going to do the same with, now I'm going to do the same with the strawberry. And as I said, because it's jello, the moisture from the butter is making it wet. So you may need to add more flour. Just keep adding it until you get the crumble. Mix those together. and try to spread it out evenly. And I'm going to bake this for about 15 minutes on 350 degrees. Once I take it out, I will put it in the freezer to cool off and harden, and then I will break it up and show you what it looks like. Okay, now that we have our cake crumb coated and cooled, I'm gonna put another layer of icing on, and then I'm gonna apply our crumb mix that we made. The second layer of icing doesn't have to be thick, just enough so that the crumbs stick on it. This part is going to get messy, so I use the same cookie sheet that I made our crumble on, and I just take a handful of crumbs, sprinkle it on top, and even it out, pressing it down some, not too hard. Pushing it to the edge. For the sides, I just take a handful and I press the crumbs into the side of the cake. I use my fingers to brush the extra crumbs onto the tray so I can reuse them and get them out of the way. You want to make sure when you're applying the crumbs to the side that you are going up to that edge so you still have a neat looking cake. You want to make sure to pack those crumbs against the cake, not too hard. so that your handprint will be in the cake, but enough to stick those crumbs on there. Do that all around the cake. I'm going to clean these crumbs up and I will come back to show you the next step. Okay, for the next step, I filled a piping bag with some buttercream and a 1M star tip so we can pipe a border around. And I filled a piping bag with some of the strawberry glaze to drizzle over top. I'm going to take a knife and make an indentation, because if I just put the icing on top of these crumbs, it's not going to stick. So this is where I will put icing so that we can stick our strawberries and our cookies on top. A simple border around the bottom. It's more so just going to be in front of the cake, because like I said, the icing is not really going to stick to the cake crumbs. Gather all the leaves like this, and I'm going to dip it in the strawberry glaze. Shake off some of the excess, and I'm just going to sit it on the icing, pressing down gently. Show you again. Gather all the leaves, dip it and the strawberry glaze, shake some of the excess off, and place them in between the strawberries on the icing. Just like that. done.